the female, half the females are now sent to the veal pens also because they produce so many calves that they don't even need all the females anymore. So the veal calves are not all male calves anymore. Fully a third of them are female calves. That just had that calf, she has her baby taken away when it's born, and she's milked. And she's milked for about 3 months, and then her milk production starts to fall off because after about 3 months, the calf will be big enough to be eating some grass and things on its own. So the farmers don't want that to happen, so she's impregnated again, artificially, of course. And for the next 9 months, she's being milked while she's pregnant. You can imagine how many growth hormones her body's trying to make to put into that milk so that she can feed the calf she thinks she's feeding now, get it grown up enough so that the next calf on its way is going to be able to get some milk and be able to grow up. So for 9 months, she's milked while she's pregnant. She gives birth again. That calf is taken away. 3 months later, she's impregnated again. For nine months, she's milked while she's pregnant. So for most of her life, she's being milked while she's pregnant. After about two or three pregnancies, her body really is osteoporotic. She's produced two or three full-grown calves. She's given milk, gallons and gallons of milk every day of her adult life, and her bones really are shot. And at the age of 4 or 5, most of these dairy cows can barely walk because they're so truly osteoporotic. 10% of them can't walk on their own, and they have to be dragged to the slaughterhouse floor to be turned into that hamburger meat. So at the age of 4 or 5, you have these cows that are basically teenagers, but they're old ladies physiologically, and that's the reward they get for giving us all this milk, and that's why that meat is so cheap, because those cows have already paid their dues, so they can sell their burgers for 99 cents. Incidentally, that's where all the meat comes from that's given away and sold in the school lunch program. It's from dairy cows. Remember that underground footage of that slaughterhouse in California where they were dragging cows by chains, trains and forklifts at Hallmark Slaughterhouse? That slaughterhouse only slaughters dairy cows. Those dairy cows that they were dragging, they said, we got to recall all this meat because they might have mad cow disease. They knew darn well those cows didn't have mad cow disease. They were dairy cows. That happens every day. 10% of those cows cannot walk on their own, and they're dragged to the slaughterhouse floor. The problem with that was that we got footage of it, and people saw it. But it goes on every day, and that's where our cheap hamburger meat comes from, and that's the price, that's the real price of those hamburgers. And that's why that meat is so full of growth hormones, because those cows are still lactating. On their way to being dragged to the slaughterhouse floor, there's still milk dripping out of their nipples. They're not going to waste time. They're not going to wait until their nipples dry up, until their udders dry up. They're still lactating, and that's the meat that we're being served, is meat that's full of growth hormones. So it's not just dairy products. It's all this cheap hamburger meat that's sold in these fast food places and Taco Bell and Pizza Hut. And that's why we have such a cancer epidemic, because we're consuming growth hormones, not just in the milk, but in beef, and also in all meat, in the chickens. Chickens are injected with growth hormones, so a chicken can, from the time it hatches out of an egg, in 45 days it's full grown. A chicken should take a year to be full grown, but they're pumped so full of hormones that they grow to full size in 45 days. That's full of growth hormones also. No wonder we have a cancer epidemic. Growth hormones stimulate cancer growth by telling the immune system, if you think about what a growth hormone is, it tells the body when cells divide, the old cell would normally be gotten rid of by the immune system and the new cell would take its place. And that's how if you're full grown, you're not going to grow anymore. So when your cells divide, one is gotten rid of while the new one takes its place. If you're going to grow, you can't get rid of all the old cells. If you just divide one for one and lose one, you stay the same size. So growth hormones tell the immune system, don't get rid of all the old cells. Let some stay there so we can grow. Now, cancer cells are seen as old cells, and the immune system wants to get rid of them, but these growth hormones suppress the message of the immune system and let some of those cells stay in place. And that's why growth hormones fuel cancer growth, because they don't allow the immune system to do its work. And anybody that tells you that they're eating a low-fat diet and they're doing themselves a favor as far as cancer, they're totally misinformed. All these growth hormones are proteins. So the higher the protein in the food, the more growth hormones in there. Whether it's chicken or beef or dairy products or eggs or fish. All the fish that we catch now are smaller and smaller fish because we fished out all the big ones. All the fish farms kill the fish before they're full grown. So they're full of growth hormones also. All animal protein is full of growth hormones and is keeping your immune system from fighting cancer the way it should. There was a study that just came out last year in the European Journal of Cancer Prevention that said for every serving of flesh food, whether it's chicken, fish, beef, pork, whatever, every serving of flesh food increases a woman's